So how would you describe a pollinator? Well, a new plant comes from a seed. But where does that seed come from? And that's where the pollinators come in.
A pollinator is some sort of a creature, whether it's an insect or an animal, that moves pollen from one part of a plant to another. And pollen is almost sort of like little teeny, itty-bitty seeds in the plant. And once they're moved into a deeper part of the flower, they can then sort of grow into bigger seeds and a fruit or things that people or animals can eat.
And seeds are often surrounded by fruit and vegetables and berries, and grains are seeds and nuts are seeds. So there's all kinds of seeds that plants need to produce. Problem is that plants can't move, so they need some animal helpers to move these special cells around for them.
When those seeds inside get planted, new plants grow, create flowers, and when pollinated, create more fruit, and the whole cycle of life continues.
So we've got all kinds of pollinators, without which there would be very little for people to eat, very little for other animals to eat. There wouldn't be fruits, vegetables, nuts, grains. We'd all be pretty hungry.
Now, what are some threats to pollinators' populations?
The two biggest things that are causing the pollinators to have problems are habitat loss and overuse of pesticides. And both of those problems are created by people. People are chopping down forests and meadows all over the place, and then they're spraying all those big lawns with terrible chemicals. And these chemicals, a lot of what they'll do is they weaken their immune systems. So a pollinator that may be able to fight off a disease or a parasite can no longer do that.
Scientists tell us that many of the pollinators that we rely on to fertilize our plants are dying or disappearing. We have less honeybees and bumblebees, less than we had 100 years ago. Many species of butterflies also are disappearing.
All these plants need to be pollinated, but the farms are so big and they've taken up so much of the natural environment planting this stuff that there aren't enough native bees or native pollinators to do all that pollinating.
Pollinators are important because they help the plants create the fruits and a lot of the vegetables that people and wildlife eat. And both people and wildlife need a variety of foods to survive. They can't just eat one thing all the time or they'll get sick. And wildlife benefits from that too. But one of the really important things about butterflies is that they mature from caterpillars. And so if we don't have butterflies and we don't have caterpillars, there are many, many animals and insects that use those caterpillars as a protein source. So if they lose those caterpillars, they have to find another source of protein. And if there aren't enough seeds and nuts to go around for the wildlife, then that ecosystem could potentially collapse. Pollinators are also important because they are pollinating things that would not be pollinated by wind. And the wind-pollinated plants are the ones that give people the terrible allergies that they hate because the plants have to produce so much more pollen to be pollinated that way.
So what can you do to help?
If you have even a small yard, to the really, really tiny native bees, that can be a whole world to them. They don't need to go very far for forage or for shelter. So if you wanted to help little tiny native bees, then all you would need to do is plant some native plants and provide, you know, shelter for them.
And you can make sure that there are flowers growing from the springtime through late fall, so there is nectar available for all the adult butterflies.
We need to think a lot about how all of these things fit together. The honeybees, the native pollinators, all work together to create the world as we know it.